Hey everybody, it's Sean and Trey with Reactions to the Classics. Before we get started today, we just wanted to invite you to take a look at our Patreon page where we have all kinds of reward tiers, anywhere from reacting to an entire album to songs, supporting us for as little as $1 a month. It really helps us out.
And you can also check out our Facebook and Discord groups down below. Got a great community of people who love music. And all that to say, y'all, let's get to today's video.
What's happening, everybody? Trey here, joined again by my dad, Sean. And today, we got a monster song from Traffic here.
We do.
Haven't ever done, I don't think, any Traffic on the channel, the great Steve Winwood. We got the low spark of High-Heeled Boys. This comes courtesy of our patron, Bob. Shout out to Bob. Appreciate
Thank you, Bob.
The support, brother. And before we get into the tune, we'll just kind of go over some of the facts of this mammoth song.
Yeah, it's a title song from their 1971 album, written by Jim Capaldi and a little bit from Winwood. The title refers to an inscription written by, he's a short guy, American actor Michael J. Pollard in Jim Capaldi's notebook while they were both in Morocco. Capaldi and Pollard were planning to work on a movie that was never filmed. Capaldi said, Pollard and I would sit around writing lyrics all day, talking about Bob Dylan and the band, thinking up ridiculous plots for this movie that never happened. Before they left Morocco, Pollard wrote in Capaldi's book, The Low Spark of High Heel Boys.
So yeah, I was wondering how.
I was too, so that's why I'm giving you guys the long story of it. But I imagine he was shocked when he saw it actually on the album. And for Capaldi said, for me, it summed him up. He had this tremendous rebel attitude. He walked around in his cowboy boots, his leather jacket. At the time, he was a heavy little dude. It seemed to sum up all the people of that generation. We were just rebels. The low spark for me was the spirit. High-spirited, you know, standing on a street corner, the low rider, the low spark, meaning that strong undercurrent at the street level. Now, yeah, it's almost 12 minutes long. The most important, the most interesting part of this story for me was Winwood was actually recording this, laying down the lyrics in the studio, and Capaldi, a third verse came to him. He wrote it out by hand and slid it in front of Winwood while Winwood was in the middle of recording, because it was only two verses before. That's insane, man.
That's why I like that we kind of dive into the backstory of these tunes before we listen
to them. Yeah, and it's insane on two levels, right? Yeah. It's insane that Capaldi just writes these lyrics right then while he's singing the song, and then it's insane that Winwood just slide it in front of him. He just keeps rolling, man. So, I mean, that's some talent on both sides.
Oh, definitely. And I'm glad we got that backstory. We're going to pull up
yeah,
the lyrics.
That build up, I'm looking forward
to. Yeah, we'll kind of say our thoughts as the song's going on, but really save kind of the meat of the reaction to the end. I don't know how Traffic is on copyright, so if we end up having to chop this out, there will be a link in the description if you want the full audio.
Exactly. We don't know.
Going blind since we've never done them before on YouTube. But enough talk. Let's get rocking, man. Faking me out with the silence.
I'm like, is it on?
I figured with a near 12-minute song, we're gonna have a long,
a little slow
intro,
percolating. Like they did a lot more in the 60s and 70s, man. They let a song, I always say, breathe.
Little jazzy type feel to it here. That means we got to get that nice Hammond organ.
Yeah, we do, man.
As always.
The Hammond organs were everywhere.
Just can't escape from the worry too much, it'll happen to you. We were children once, playing with toys. And the thing that you're hearing is only the sound of the love spark of high-heeled boys.
We haven't really had the guitar be the focal point at all, and then they're bringing it here kind of at the climax of the tune. job of kind of like building something up, letting that tension go, and then bring us back.
Yeah. Yeah, just going all the way.
Say, let's keep this ride. Let's ride this wave for as long as we can. Spark of high-heeled boys, traffic, in the bag, man. There we go. A lot more jazz-centric, fusion-y, you know, rock and jazz fusion in there. A lot of different instruments from, you know, of course, the electric guitar, and then the organ, the keyboard, you know, some brass in there, the congas, a little bit of everything for everybody here. I enjoyed the message of the tune too, kind of hitting, especially here we're in 71, hitting at the record executives.
Yes.
That you know, the percentage you're paying is too high while you're living beyond all your means, and the man in the suit has just bought a new car from the profit he's made on your dreams. That was my favorite.
Yeah, mine too.
Set of lines in the chorus. And it mentioned in here how just you can't escape from the sound. Don't worry too much; it'll happen to you. You know how music kind of engrosses all of us in a certain way here. And then at the end, kind of thinking that he could give everything to somebody, maybe the music industry in itself, he has nothing for in return. Would you do the same for me as I would for you, or would you take me for a ride mm-hmm. and strip me of everything, including my pride? But it ends on a bit of a hopeful note, but spirit is something that no one destroys. So those are my positives of the song. I enjoyed the instrumental sections. I thought it probably could have been chopped a few minutes kind of in the middle there where we got that second guitar solo. I think maybe that could have been shortened down. Not that it was bad, but...
No, it wasn't bad.
It was almost like we got, you know, back to back of this. I wanted something a little different in that second section there of the instrumental solos.
Yeah, I think I like the chorus the best when Winwood mm-hmm. built up. I think it's one of those songs that's hard to do on a first reaction mm-hmm. because I think it's a song that has to build on you. But it's what this is to me is a concert song.
Yes.
Right? It's a jam out song. It's like, okay, now we're going to focus on this. Now we're going to focus mm-hmm. on, let's get the spotlight here. Let's let this guy get some water. Let's really show off our first class musicianship, yeah. which is what this is. But I'm with you. It's almost 12 minutes. I feel like if it was almost 7 minutes mm-hmm. or almost 8 minutes, it would be much better. But also, like I said, it's phenomenal yeah. musicianship, right? So it's kind of one of those things that you have to let marinate on exactly. yourself. You have to listen to it on multiple listens. So on a first listen for me, it's a 6.5.
Mm-hmm. I got a... Yeah, that's one of those
hard. It's hard. Like, it's still really good. Like, the ability of these guys, mm-hmm. just as true musicians, is freaking off the charts.
And, yeah, I wish we had maybe a little more dash of energy here and there. Yet yeah. It's weird. My negatives are almost more personal preferences because
I agree.
The musicianship itself was phenomenal. So, yeah, this is a tough one for me to grade because is it one I'd spin on repeat? And probably not... not in particular yet. I'm still glad I listened
to it. No, I'm glad I listened to it. See, I've never really listened to Traffic, and you kind of get an idea of like, wow, these guys were something else.
And I mean, it does make me want to listen to more of what they got to offer.
Yeah.
I'll be in the 7.5 range just for how top-notch the musicianship was, and I did like the message behind the song, my negatives of the tune aside. I mean,
still a good tune, man.
I dug it, man. So thank you to Bob.
Thanks, Bob.
For that. Let us know what you think of the song down below. Any more Traffic we should check out. If you haven't already, be sure to hit that big thumbs up, that big red subscribe button. And if you'd like for us to react to a song, you can check out our Patreon page. And until next time, y'all, thank you for watching. Happy listening, and we will.